In this class, I am going to discuss about the basic things associated with the Galois field, right? And now in the regular classes, we discussed the unit number 1 and unit number 2, 3 and 4 and 6. And the remaining leftover unit is unit number 5. And this unit is about BCH codes and RS codes. And in this particular lecture, I am going to discuss about the things those are required for the BCH codes. That means what are the basic things required in order to understand the concepts associated with the BCH codes. And those are required to understand the BCH codes are Galois fields, and it is very easy a concept. And this particular Galois field applications are cryptography and information theory. Particularly this Galois field concept is used in the cryptography and coding theory, right? And in order to understand the concepts of the BCH code, compulsory we must need this Galois field. So now in this lecture, I am going to discuss about the basic things associated with the Galois field, right? And now this is about the Galois field. And this particular Galois field is introduced by the scientist named called Galois. In the Galois field, how many number of elements are present within the Galois field? The number of elements present within the Galois field is equal to positive integer power of a prime number. That means this is the positive integer, and the power of the prime number is a positive integer. This is nothing but the number of elements present within the given Galois field, right? And now one more thing is Galois field is a field in which the number of elements is always a positive integer power of a prime number. And this is the definition of the Galois field, right? So now representation, how we can represent the Galois field. Representation of the Galois field is with a two letters GF, where G is the Galio and F is a field. And this is the notation used to represent the Galois field, right? And now Galois field is represent GF of Q. What is Q? And here Q is a prime number, that is Q is equal to P. That means Q may be a prime number or it may be a power of a prime number. That means Q is a prime number or it may be a power to a prime number, where P is a prime number, right? So now, where P is nothing but prime number. So that means finally, it is the definition of the Galois field, and it is a representation of the Galois field. The number of elements present within the Galois field is equal to power of, that means a positive integer power of prime number, right? So now, so it is the finally the representation of the Galois field. Next, I will go to the one example with respect to the Galois field. It is the example related to the Galois field. Example 1, and now it is a Galois. G means Galio, F means field. Galois field of 2 power 3. Here 2 power 3 means 8. How many elements are there in the Galois field of 2 power 3? I will read this particular thing. A Galois field Galio's field of 2 power 3, Galio field 2 power 3, right? So now, in this particular Galio's field 2 power 3, how many number of elements are there? So here, in the brackets, we have 2 power 3. 2 power 3 means 8. Therefore, in this particular Galio field, we have 8 number of elements. How we can represent the elements within this particular Galio field 2 power 3? And so the number of elements in any Galio field, the first two elements are represented by 0 and 1. And the remaining elements are represented by alpha to the power 1, alpha to the power 2, alpha to the power 3, alpha to the power 4, alpha to the power 5, alpha to the power 6. And now this particular one is called as alpha to the power 0. We know that anything to the power of 0 is equal to 1. That's why here it is equal to 1. Right. So now entire within this particular Galio field 2 power 3. So we have 8 elements. Those 8 elements are represented by 0, 1, alpha, alpha square, alpha cube, alpha power 4, alpha 5, alpha power 6. Right. Entire out of all these 8 elements, we have 1 0 element and 7 non-zero elements. And now the remaining 7 non-zero elements are represented by one letter that is called, one common letter that is called alpha, right? So here out of these 8 elements, we have 1 0 element and 7 non-zero elements. These 7 non-zero elements are represented by one common letter that is called alpha. This particularly in Galio's field, this common letter used to represent the non-zero elements is called a primitive element, right? So 7 non-zero elements within this particular Galio field 2 power 3 are represented by one common letter that is called alpha. This common letter alpha is nothing but primitive element, right? Sorry. So here particularly alpha is called as a primitive element. Why? Because why we call this particular alpha as a primitive element? So since we representing all the non-zero elements within this particular field by alpha, therefore this particular alpha is called as a primitive element, right? So we can represent all the remaining non-zero elements of the group by the common letter that is called alpha. That's why this particular alpha is called as a primitive element. Is it okay? Right. And now coming to the second example, Galio. In the last case we cover about the Galio's field 2 power 3. In this particular Galio field we have 8 number of elements. Now let us consider the Galio field second example. Now the Galio field considered is 2 power 4 Galio field. Galio field 2 power 4. So here inside of the bracket we have 2 power 4. Say, right. So therefore here 2 power 4 means 16. Therefore in this particular Galio field 2 power 4 we have 16 elements. Right, and the representation of all these 16 elements as, right, so now Galio field 2 power 4, and this one is a representation of the Galio field 2 power 4. And how many elements are there within this particular Galio field 2 power 4? 16 elements are there. So these 16 elements are represented by 0, 1, alpha, alpha square, alpha cube, alpha power 4, alpha 5, alpha to the power 6, alpha to the power 7, alpha to the power 8, alpha to the power 9, alpha to the power 10, alpha to the power 11, alpha to the power 12, alpha to the power 11, alpha to the power 14. So right, first two elements are 0 and 1, and this one is nothing but alpha power 0, and it is equal to 1. Right, so again this alpha is called as, right, so here now cover what is the representation of Galio field 2 power 3. And in order to understand the remaining concepts in the Galio field, you need to understand the two things. Galio field 2 power 3. How many elements are there? 8 elements are there, right? In the Galio field 2 power 4. How many elements are there? 16 elements are there. These 8 elements are represented by 0, 1, alpha, alpha 2 and up to alpha 6, right? And now, next one, 16 elements are there in the Galio field 2 power 3 and those elements are represented 0, 1, alpha, alpha power 2, alpha power 3 and so on up to alpha power 14. And these two things are very important in order to understand the remaining concepts available in the Galio's field. Right. All of you please remember these two concepts. GF of 2 power 3 and GF of 2 power 4. GF of 2 power 3, 8 elements. Representation for the 8 elements. GF of 2 power 4. Galio field 2 power 4. 16 elements are there, within this particular Galio field 2 power 4. Those 16 elements are represented by 0, 1, alpha, alpha square and so on up to alpha power 4. And this particular concept is very, very important in order to understand the remaining concepts. So all of you please remember these two basics. Right? Now why we go for this? So these primitive elements, this is alpha. Alpha is called, alpha is nothing but primitive element. Why this particular primitive element, why particularly these primitive elements are very important, right? These primitive elements are used to calculate the minimal polynomial of the BCH codes and minimal polynomial of the RS codes, right? So now, and in order to construct the generator polynomial for the BCH code and in order to construct the generator polynomial for the RS codes, compulsory we must need the basic concepts of primitive elements, right? That's why we introduce the primitive elements in the Galio's field, right? So finally it is concluded that these primitive elements are very much essential to construct the generator polynomial of the BCH codes and RS codes. That's why we move to the primitive elements, right? So now, what is meant by primitive polynomial? So let us consider the primitive polynomial. Let P of X is a irreducible polynomial. That means further we cannot able to reduce this particular polynomial. Let that particular polynomial be P of X, right? Consider P of X as a irreducible polynomial. And this, for this particular polynomial, let us assume the degree as M. Let M be the degree of the polynomial P of X, right? And what about the n? N is the smallest positive integer, right? And now, and it is the definition of the primitive polynomial. P of X is the reducible polynomial. M is the degree of the P of X. N is the smallest positive integer, right? And now, P of X of order degree or degree M is said to be a primitive polynomial if it satisfies this particular condition, right? If any polynomial satisfies this condition, then that particular polynomial is said to be a primitive polynomial, right? If any polynomial P of X of order or degree M is said to be a primitive polynomial, if this particular P of X satisfies the condition P of X, the smallest positive integer n for which P of X divides the x power n plus 1 is n equal to 2 power m minus 1. The smallest positive integer n for which P of X divides x of n x power n plus 1 is n equal to 2 power m minus 1. right? Any polynomial which satisfy that this particular condition, that particular polynomial can be considered as a primitive polynomial. This is the definition for primitive polynomial, right? And now let us consider the what is the primitive polynomial for the 2 power Galio field 2 power 3 and Galio field 2 power Galio field 2 power, right? Primitive polynomial example, primitive polynomial examples, right? Exam primitive polynomial. What is primitive polynomial? Already I explained earlier, right? So what is primitive polynomial for the degree m is equal to 3 and 4, 5, 6, right? And now for the degree m, the primitive polynomials are 1 plus x plus x cube and 1 plus x square plus x cube. For the degree 4, this is the primitive polynomial, and for the degree 5, this is the primitive polynomial, and for the degree 6, it is the primitive polynomial, right? So now all these results are tabulated in the one table. That particular table is here, I mentioned, right? I won't further in detail about the about this particular primitive polynomial. And all these things are very much essential in order to understand the things associated with the BCH code. That's why in brief I will discuss all these things, right? So this is the, for the degree 2, this is a primitive polynomial. For the degree 3, this is a, these are the two primitive polynomials. For the degree 4, this is a primitive polynomial. For the degree 5, this is a primitive polynomial. For the degree 6, this is the primitive polynomial, right? All of you please remember, at least for the degree, at least for up to degree 6, you need to remember all the polynomials, right?